something happened on Family Feud, and it's actually, you know, as they say, it's gone viral. Everybody's talking about it. Mm-hmm. It's behind the scenes shit that happened with Family Feud that nobody's seen before.
No. Oh.
But it had to be seen to be believed. Now we watch. Okay, out of all the game shows I watch, there's two of them where people just get made to look dumb.
Mm-hmm.
At least that I know of. It's Wheel of Fortune and Family Feud. And I was
Price is Right.
You know what? You got it.
Yeah.
Some pretty dumb motherfuckers on Price is Right too.
Really weird too.
They still got that show
somewhere out there. The Game Show Network's a thing.
Okay. No, they. You know, they, man, it's a history of stupidity on these right. shows. The only place you're gonna see where they do dumb answers that's, you know, that you're dumber than is Jeopardy.
Yeah.
The dumbest answer on Jeopardy is way smarter than me.
Well, that's the thing, yeah. If you don't answer a question on Jeopardy, nobody goes like, oh, you stupid.
Yeah.
They're like, well, that was hard, you know.
I stopped watching Jeopardy because I got tired of saying, fuck you. You know?
Beck.
Yeah.
They make smarter than me.
I've lost too many TVs from watching Jeopardy, just throwing shit at it. But Family Feud, man. My mom and I used to watch Family Feud with the rest of my family, and this brings me back to the day when I used to watch Family Feud with my family, especially my mom, because that is the one where they would give some of the dumbest answers, and they would actually give you time sometimes to correct your answer. You had time to think about it.
Yeah.
And the people would applaud, you know, rewarding you for your dumb answer. Good answer. You made a shit good answer.
Yeah. I hate that.
Yeah. Good answer.
Family, man. Come on.
No, fuck that. Stupid answer.
The first ones, you go like, the fuck? Why would you say something like
exactly.
that?
Exactly.
And the funniest thing is, you always can tell that they had to, by sheer numbers. They had a slot open. They had to bring the dumbest person in the family.
Yeah.
And they would always fuck them up. And that's the case right here. Now, why is this so nostalgic for me and my mother watching this? Well, let's go ahead and take a look at this. This is epic, spectacularly, and it's long too. One of the worst answers that I've seen in the history of wrong answers in game shows.
Tell me another way people say mother.
Mama.
Mama.
Mommy.
Mommy.
Now you're saying, Corey, where's that, you know, number two, number one? Where's the dumb answer at? I had to show you those two answers right there to give you some context at the epic fucking stupidity you're about to see right now.
Yolan, tell me another way people say mother.
Nanny.
Really, but
Nanny!
Yeah.
Okay, wrong. Yeah. You expected that.
Right.
And you're saying, okay, I mean, yeah, she could probably thought of something else, but why is that such a big deal? Oh, this is where we drive off the cliff.
Cecilia, name another way people say mother.
How about Nana?
Okay. She looking at the camera. Yeah, I got this.
Yeah, she looking at the she looking at like, that's a great answer. Steve Harvey got one thing down. He can call you a dumb motherfucker with just a look. I mean, look at that. You can never be so insulted by a bottom lip like you have with Steve Harvey.
What if he did that for himself when he pronounced the wrong winner at the Miss Universe contest?
I'm sure he did look like that.
He did that backstage when he ran off.
Oh, yeah. Believe me, had this been after, he wouldn't have been so shitty. He wouldn't have been talking that shit. But this was before. Now, you see what's happening here now. This family right here, they think that just by inflection or just rearranging, you know, sort of the pronunciation of things.
She didn't say it right. She said, Nanny.
Yeah.
Nah, nah.
Oh, Martin, you said you didn't see this.
Oh, I saw it.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Nah, nah. Sheila, tell me another way people say mother.
What about Steve? Nana?
Are you kidding me?
My mother used to be so angry about this shit. There's nothing more than that made my mother upset than looking at dumb black people on game shows.
Your mother like this bitch.
That's my mother. My mother would have been like, this motherfucker here in front of a 6-year-old. Nothing made her so angry.
Don't clap.
Yeah, you say it.
Nana?
Didn't you say Nana?
I did say that, Steve, yes.
Nana.
Uh-huh. And I said, Nana?
And they change your answer.
Well, what is you saying? Stop clapping.
I was glad he said that. I'm like, why y'all doing
what
this?
What you clapping for?
Yeah. You know the plow sign ain't on and shit. Trying to reward this woman for her fucking ignorance. Even Steve Harvey is doing his best not to say the word retarded right now.
What, is you trying to say it in Spanish or something? It's the same word.
It's the same word.
They're going to spell it the same way. E-N-A-E-N-A. You just can't go changing the inflection. And no, can't be your one.
Sad thing is, he was going to do it.
Exactly.
He was going to do it. Look at
him.
Look, he knew. He was like, ah, you got me, brother.
Tell me another way people say mother.
What about mommy?
Can she not read?
She might be illiterate. We don't
know.
Oh,
man.
This is where my mother, she would see this shit. For my mother, black people on game shows were ambassadors for black people. They would speak for black people.
Right.
Nothing made her so upset as looking at this. Is my mother turned racist with this shit.
Oh, hell yeah. We didn't have water hoses and dogs sicked on us for this.
For this shit right here. For this shit right here. With a simple game show.
Yeah.
We back 10 steps. Taking us back beyond the civil rights movement.
Sure.
Thing is, man, my mother used to get upset because it contradicted what happened here. She said these black people are on these shows because they're well spoken, but they say the dumbest shit. So in my mom's mind, the white people looking at this like, even when they're well-spoken, they're still stupid. My mother used to look at this and she
thought about it.
My mother used to look at this and she would be the most, I'm sorry, but she used to be the most racist person. She's like, you dumb nigga, that ain't how you say it. That ain't that she used to hate this shit, man.
Y'all already
said,
get off mommy.
Yeah,
not alone.
You wonder why I get it, my mother, and I can't blame her. My mother went through some torment.
My dad was the same way. Man, he would cuss people out on Wheel of Fortune.
Yeah.
If they couldn't guess that an S went somewhere, you're like, what the fuck? How dumb are these people?
Yeah. And see, older.
I'm like, Dad, why you keep watching the show?
Oh, yeah. And older black people, you know, they still got these conspiracy theories going on.
Yeah.
So my mom used to think that they used to actually recruit dumb black people to be on game shows so that they could just make everybody look bad.
I don't think that's a conspiracy theory.
You know,
I think that's the truth.
They do it for the news.
They do it for the news.
And reality TV.
Oh, that's true.
There was a time I didn't believe it.
Yeah.
There was a time I said, no. You know, I used to be Luke Skywalker. No, that can't be true. But after looking at this shit, there's no other way. They look at this and they say, this is pure entertainment. Yeah, get your ignorant ass on up here. Yeah, I mean, you know, and if black people won, it was just by accident. You
know? Damn.
I mean, because after seeing this, there's no fucking way these people came on without some kind of vetting process, you know?
See, look at me. Y'all stop laughing at this. This ain't. See, watch how I do this. Mommy. See that? Mommy. Now watch this here. Mommy. Man, tell.
And this is what's so funny about it. You push black people enough, no matter how professional you are, no matter how many white people you're in front of, you push them enough that black's gonna come out. They pushed this man to be so unprofessional, he just pretty much said, fuck a paycheck.
Right.
Another way people say mother.
Okay, Steve. Nana.
She's serious.
She's serious. This is not a joke.
Dead serious.
In that last part, she was laughing. You can see she started getting embarrassed.
Yeah.
She had nothing. Nothing at all.
Did say pass?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Will,
I don't know. If she
Will,
knows.
As Will, I, you know,
we're trying to get his undergrad in black studies right now.
I like the way Will is actually looking at us now.
Yeah,
like why
does he not know?
What is wrong? Will is asking us, what is wrong with your people?
Did they explain the rules to him?
Can you guys translate for me? What's happening?
Can you guys help me help you? Will, we don't know, brother.
Yeah,
we don't know, man.
As confused as you are.
I wish I could give you. I feel embarrassed right now, but I wish I could tell you.
I would chalk it to a lack of experience with the rest of the world.
Yeah.
But
he don't give a fuck anymore. Watch this. That's where the black gonna come out.
This shit can't be happening. Listen to me. I get paid to host a show. Get too much shit here. Here we go.
Nah, they just drove him delirious. Oh,
he's completely gone crazy.
they drove the motherfucker crazy, man. All he could do was just laugh.
Tell me another way people say, no, nah, just hell, just tell me another way you say mother, because.
Hell.
Well, Steve, I would say mom, but the answer mom is already up there.
Okay. Right, well, let's just flip that shit over.
That's the best thing I've ever
seen. Yeah, even Steve Harvey's like, man, what the fuck you waiting on?
Yeah, give him the goddamn
ass. Put the fucking X up right now. Shit. You ain't got all day.
That is great.
This is the point my mother had day would be ruined. These dumb niggas on these soaps.
Put on fucking TV.
I don't know what to say.
That's the most I've heard Steve Harvey cuss since the original cancel comedy.
He was trying to, brother. He was trying to be clean.
Trying to be wholesome. It's a wholesome family show.
They brought the Negro out in his ass. He couldn't help it.
That man was about to quit right there.
He really was.
I know it crossed his mind.
Fuck. Will, shit.
The fact that they were singing along with him, that would have insulted me. I would have been like, shut the fuck up.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. Like, this is not funny. This is not a game.
It just makes me mad.
No,
it's not a game.
It's
not a game. See, Will, you don't understand. That's what you don't understand. Yeah. For you and white people, it's a game. For us, it is not.
Nah, it means so much more, Will.
For us, these people are spokesmen for and spokeswomen for us, you know? For us, they might as well be goddamn Martin Luther King up here, you know? See, here's the thing, man. This is what I'm going to tell you. Like, again, it's one of those things where white people can fuck up on these shows. That's why black people look at it like, man, you can't do this. Because when you fuck up,
you make
when you look stupid, all the black people look stupid. They had a college student that came on. It was kind of dumb. You remember this shit from, I forgot I had this clip. You remember that shit from Wheel of Fortune?
Oh, fuck.
Dude fucked up $1 million.
Oh, yeah. When me and Will did the show, he ran that clip.
Okay, if y'all haven't seen it, I got the clip. The dude lost $1 million because he couldn't say Achilles. Wow. he said Wendy's chili.
L.
Yeah, four L's. Lay it down right over that London trip down there. Wow. Okay.
I saw.
Oh, well, that'd be a good idea. Yeah.
Mythological hero Achilles.
Ageless.
Dude, not only did he make himself and black folk look bad, he made Indiana State look bad.
Yeah, very much so.
He's wearing that huge logo right there.
Yeah.
It's like, wow, they don't teach you nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The girl, look at the girl. Yeah, that girl, like, you dumb motherfucker. You.
I never noticed that.
It's a combination of you fucking idiot and thank you.
Yeah.
And look at him. He knew right then. He like, fuck. And see why it looks bad? Because he's a college student. But somewhere, a large portion of white people say, see, Indiana, that's what you get for affirmative action. Letting them in. They don't learn a fucking thing.
That's what she was thinking.
She's like, I'm so glad I didn't go there.
Oh, that's how I was going to have to fuck you to get some of that money. Now I can just win it legitimately.
And she has 600.
Yeah. Not anymore.
She's losing it.
This brother. You see, he could have been nervous.
No, he just didn't know. Because he said it out loud and proud.
Yeah.
Mythological hero, Achilles.
Achilles!
You ate chilies.
So not only he can't pronunciate, and he goes to fucking college. Come on, man.
Well,
that's a bad look.
Obviously, he hasn't taken Greek mythology yet, so hey.
You don't have to. Basic English, you can just do that. He had to literally read. He couldn't do that right.
Yeah, it's too bad they don't have any kind of Greek clubs at colleges.
Yeah, right.
Who knows? His whole life, he's probably been going around like, man, they cut his Achilles heel, man. You know?
And nobody corrected
him. And nobody ever corrected him.
Yeah, his whole life.
He sure did.
Yeah. He might be on Wheel of Fortune one day. I might be going up against him. Don't tell him. he thought he had this. You're like, oh, you mean I fucked up? Yeah, brother.
Yeah, I mean, that moment when you say it out loud and people don't, you know, the sirens don't go off and people aren't cheering. Oh, that stage act is like,
oh, it's all gasps too. And shit.
And here's the, you think that girl's expression is funny? Sometimes Pat Sajak just wants to say something so bad. He wants to say, you fucking idiot. And he can't say, look at the look on his face.
I can't accept that. Okay.
Yeah.
You can't accept that.
You know, everybody says being a comedian, you know, comedians are really depressed in real life. I feel like game show hosts, like, have to pull the gun out of their mouth, like, every day.
how many Family Feud hosts have got?
That's what I'm saying. This dude looks miserable now.
He does. He has to see this shit.
Can't believe I'm still doing this.
Day after fucking day, man.
Like, who was the genius that was on Jeopardy that was there for, like, 36
weeks? Oh, that guy, yeah.
And Pat Sajak.
He hated that fucking dude.
I'm gonna kill you, man. Alex Trebek.
Anyway, people. Anyway, know your shit before you go on a game show, please. Especially if you're black.
How do
make us
get
look
past,
good.
Though?
I don't know. Shit, I don't even think that. You know what? I don't even think this brother was in college.
Honestly, a clue was that he needed to get every letter to even solve it.
Yeah, I think this motherfucker, I think that he actually, I think he bought that shirt. I don't even think he went there.
Holding that up right there.
Yeah, he really thought he had it.
He thought he had
it. What if he was screen capped it and just posted that picture everywhere?
Yeah, and just holding that up. Just had it waiting for him when he got home and shit. I know. Yeah. Like he's black Charlie Brown. You blockhead.
He kind of looks like
that. Yeah, he looked like black Charlie Brown.
It's Franklin.
Yeah.
You Franklin in college.
You fucking asshole. His dog is there looking at him. Fuck you, man. I ain't going home with you.
That really was a Charlie Brown moment. It really was.
Was
it the Spelling Bee episode?
Yeah. Ass just pops off the screen.